And Herschel's yield is a weakness in spite of overall strength, which can lead to downfall. In Greek mythology, when Achilles was an infant, it was predicted that he would perish at a young age. To prevent his death, his mother, Thetis, took Achilles to River Styx, which was believed to offer powers of invulnerability. She dipped his body in the water, but because she held him by his heel, it was not touched by the water of the river. Achilles grew up to be a man of war who survived many great battles, but at the Trojan War, an arrow, possibly poisoned and shot by Paris, hit his heel, the only part not touched by River Styx water, and which had no power of invulnerability. Achilles became invulnerable where the water touched him, that is, everywhere except the area of his heel, that were covered by his mother's thumb and four fingers. Thus, Achilles' heel became expression meaning area of weakness or vulnerable spot, a part whose failure will disrupt the entire system. Welcome to Success Digest, where we simplify and discuss things that are needed for your financial independence and live a happy life. My name is Kayo Denrighton, the publisher of Success Digest video series and the CEO of Kenny's Consult Limited, a financial service firm that is based in London. Today, I'm going to discuss with you on the topic, avoiding risk in business. Avoiding risk in business. Risk is described as a possible adverse event or outcome. It is the probability of a negative outcome to a decision or event. Please note the word probability in this definition. To avoid is to keep clear of. For the purpose of this discussion, I will refer to business as your occupation, your work, or trade. Avoiding risk in business is therefore keeping clear of whatever will render you a failure in whatever endeavor you engage in, be it your occupation, your work, or trade. How to cover the Achilles heel of your business? Every human being who reaches the age of understanding of the purpose of success and subsequently of money wishes for it. Wishing will not bring riches, but designing riches with a state of mind that becomes an obsession, then planning definite ways and means to acquire riches and backing those plans with persistence, which does not recognize failure, will bring riches. Now that we know what brings riches, what then will prevent the manifestation of our desire to be rich? That is our focus today. I can categorically tell you today that the main obstacle that can prevent your achievement in life is you yourself. You are your own Achilles heel, and you are also the one that can make your dreams come true. You must have it engraved, stamped, and iron casted into your mindset that you can be what you will to be. You can be what you will to be. Let this become your affirmation, your mantra, your motto, whatever you want to call it. Let that high in you be determined on that fact, and when this is done, make it settled, die-casted, and never to be shamed by a non-entity who does not know you but is ready to control your mindset, to control your thoughts. You must be in control of your world within, because it is then that you can control your world without. The world within controls the world without. Look too philosophical for many, but please, I have no simpler way to explain this principle. Know this, that you are made to be whole, you are made to be perfect, to be strong, powerful, loving, harmonious, and happy. It is an exact scientific statement. This is the truth. Truth is mighty, truth will prevail, and truth will set you free. When you face any business with this knowledge of yourself, as I've just explained, you will have put yourself in the position to avoid any risk and obstacle that might come your way. You will face your business with boldness and not fear. You will be too busy radiating courage, confidence, and power. You will anticipate success by your mental attitude. You will pound barriers to pieces and leap over the charms of doubt and hesitation which fear places in your path. If you can observe this analysis as I've just explained, fear, the greatest enemy of our progress in life, will have been eliminated. I've discussed extensively with fear in one of my previous videos, and going fully into it now will amount to repetition. I advise you watch the video for full knowledge of what is fear and its effects on us. Go and observe those who that fear too much. They hardly amount to much in life. It is this personal devil that makes them to fear the past, make them to fear the present and the future. They fear themselves, they fear their enemy, they fear their friends. They fear everything and everybody. When fear is effectually and completely destroyed, your light will shine and your cloud of life will disperse and you will have discovered yourself. Please know this. It is when you discover yourself that you can be able to discover your life and be in control of yourself. Many men and women have found to their sorrow that it is easier to control a kingdom than to control themselves. Eliminate fear in your life and you stand the chance of avoiding risk in your business. Let me repeat this. Eliminate fear in your life and you stand the chance of avoiding risk in your business. Risk will surely come, but woe to him that allows risk to truncate his chances of breakthrough, his chances of success. I just discussed what can mitigate the progress of your business, and there are so many other mitigants, but I will stop here and discuss on what improves. Kenny's Consult Limited, contact Kenny's Consult Limited on one-to-one basis if you are interested on a comprehensive enlightenment on this important topic. The main component of your business success is the resources that you put in that business. The main component of your business success is the resources that you put in that business. By resources, I mean the knowledge acquired, the capital or finances invested, and other infrastructures input towards the setting up and running the business. Knowledge will not attract money unless it is organized and intelligently directed through practical plans of action and to the definite end of accumulation of money. Knowledge is power, yes, but it is only potential power. It becomes power only when and if it is organized into definite plans of action and directed to definite ends. There is one weakness in people for which there is no remedy, and it is the universal weakness of lack of ambition. Go and look at persons, especially the salary earners, who schedule their spare time to provide for further study. They seldom remain at the bottom very long. Their actions open the way for the upward climb, remove many obstacles from their path, and gain the friendly interest of those who have the power to put them in the way of opportunities. But their colleagues, who schedule their spare time to frivolous activities, they are swimming in what I call the ocean of comfort zone. Comfort zone demotivates and limits ambition. It gives a false belief that you have arrived, thereby preventing you from attaining your potentials in life. Ignorance of knowledge is the rise of abundance of mischief in such cases. The changed economic conditions prevailing since the advent of the recent pandemic have made it necessary for thousands of people to find additional or new source of income. For the majority of these, the solution to their problem may be found only by acquiring specialized knowledge. Many will be forced to change their occupation entirely. When a trader finds that a certain line of merchandise is not selling, he usually supplants it with another that is in demand. Those in service industry must do likewise. If their services do not bring adequate return in one occupation, they must change to another where broader opportunities are available. And this is a real life story. A gentleman prepared himself as a construction engineer and followed this line of work until the depression limited his income that he required. He took inventory of himself, decided to change his profession to law, went back to school and took special courses by which he prepared himself as a corporate lawyer. Despite the fact that the depression has not ended, he completed his training, passed the bar examination, and quickly built a lucrative law practice here in the UK. In fact, he's turning away clients right now. I have another friend who changed to IT. He's now laughing to the bank. The person who stops studying merely because he has finished schooling is forever hopelessly doomed to mediocrity, no matter what may be his calling. The way of success is the way of continuous pursuit of knowledge. The way of success is the continuous pursuit of knowledge. May I remind you what I call knowledge here is the same thing that I refer to as a technical know-how in my last video, of which I said the lack of it is like a car owner who cannot drive. Church is at the mercy of the driver employed to drive that car. Every skill acquired and developed has the ability to make money for you, but it has to be organized and intelligently directed through plans of action to the definite end of accumulation of money. Money is made through exchange of service, where the quality and its quantity determine the remuneration that will be received. Exchange quality service and multitudes will clear their path to your door. He who displays his sugar need not send invitation to the hands. Your business actually is ill, I mean its weakness, might be in the form of poor quality or inadequate quantity. This must be addressed when found out, before the business can experience growth. Unfortunately, few find this out and it become the actually ill. Some business actually ill is lack of alliance with like mind or on the part of the proprietor. Remember this, when two or more people align themselves in a spirit of perfect harmony for the purpose of attaining a definite end, if that alliance is faithfully observed by all whom it is composed, the alliance brings to each of those whom it is composed power that is superhuman and seemingly irresistible in nature. Nobody is an island, and the tree that stands alone in the forest suffers most. There are various hassle ill to your business that I can discuss with you here, but I'm constrained by time to continue. We do one-to-one consultation at Kenneth Consult Limited, and if you are interested on a comprehensive discussion on this important topic, please contact us and allow us to discuss with you more enlightenment and needed for becoming financially independent. We are the financial experts that specialize in financial management. We will invest your funds for you on financial instruments for you at the stock exchange and manage it for you thereafter. We will also provide training in career and skill development, business and entrepreneurial development, business counseling and mentoring, which include even youth vocational training. Let us continue to travel together on this our journey of success through the path of wisdom. To be informed is to be transformed, and not to be informed is to be deformed. My name is Siri Mekayo, the writer, like I said, and I can be reached on 074-2794-2000 or 079-517-7525. Better still, visit our website, kenneth consult limited.uk, kenneth consult limited.uk. If you are blessed by this video, please subscribe, share, and like. Also, visit our blog on YouTube for more of our video. Please enjoy your success.
Welcome to Success Digest, where you obtain ingredients for your financial abundance and financial wellness and be fully financially independent. Let us travel together on this, our journey of success, through the path of wisdom. To be informed is to be transformed. Not to be informed is to be deformed. Success Digest leads you to financial independence.